डाले बैठे
हेलो हेलो
Honorable Shri Justice Rohit Arya, Administrative Judge, my esteemed sister and brothers on the bench, Shri Pawan Pathak, President High Court Bar Association, Gwalior, Shri Ankur Modi, Shri Rohit Mishra, Additional Advocate General, High Court of Madhya Pradesh, Bench at Gwalior, Shri Praveen Kumar Nevaskar, Deputy Solicitor General, Union of India, श्री पी एस भदौरिया चेयरमैन स्टेट बार काउंसिल ऑफ मध्य प्रदेश श्री जे पी मिश्रा श्री जितेंद्र शर्मा एंड श्री राजेश शुक्ला ऑनरेबल मेंबर्स ऑफ स्टेट बार काउंसिल ऑफ मध्य प्रदेश रिस्पेक्टेड सीनियर एडवोकेट्स मेंबर्स ऑफ द बार प्रिंसिपल रजिस्ट्रार श्री अखिलेश कुमार मिश्रा ऑफिसर ऑन स्पेशल ड्यूटी श्री हितेन द्विवेदी other officers of the registry, judges of district judiciary, ladies and gentlemen. Every inning comes to an end, although sadly, but realistically. This time, we are witnessing farewell of Honorable Shri Justice Rohit Arya on the eve of his superannuation as a judge of this court. This is closure of a special inning marked with high standards of judicial excellence, with wisdom and integrity, resolute commitment for upholding the principles of fairness and empathy, and a desire to serve the institution and public with equal dedication. Justice Arya and his disposition reminds me of a shloka of Acharya Brihaspati, which I always cherish as one of the bottom lines of justice. Yavat Briyet Jatharam Tavat Swatvam Hidehinam Adhikapi Yobhimanyot Sa Steno Dand Marhati. Arthat, yadi koi vyakti apni udar purti ke liye koi aparad karta hai, to vah aparad chhamya hai. Udar purti ya pet bharne ke pashchat यदि वह अपराध करता है तो वह दंड का भागी होता है. वाइल डिस्चार्जिंग एडजुडिकेटरी और एडमिनिस्ट्रेटिव फंक्शंस, जस्टिस आर्या always made sure that its judgments, orders, and decisions must carry healing touch. In this manner, he donned the mantle of healer of the society. He always harbors the notion that law should lead to justice, and procedures are handmade to justice and not master of it. Throughout his tenure as a judge since 2013, Justice Arya delivered justice through his legal acumen, wisdom, and deep understanding of law. His judgments and articles are living testimonials of his disposition. In his celebrated article on judicial activism and social justice, published in 2020, Volume 4, MPLJ 1, in General Section, His Lordship delineated social justice, its scope and dimensions, incorporating concept of public interest litigation and judicial review. In the decision rendered in the case of Sandeep Kulshreshth versus Manoj Pratap Singh, reported in ILR January 2024, MP, page 1, while explaining the technical nature of writ of quo warranto, His Lordship, speaking for the division bench, observed that Article 226 of the constitutional jurisdiction is neither unbridled nor uncanalized. Instead, is subject to self-imposed limitations. In yet another decision delivered in the case of Jajpal Singh versus Laddu Ram Kori, reported in ILR October 2023-1715. His Lordship is speaking for the division bench, while harping upon the vice of excessive jurisdiction, observed that merely for not adopting the original profession of his forefathers, the claim of an applicant for caste certificate cannot be washed away merely on the ground that his traits do not match his tribe's peculiar anthropological and ethnological traits, deity, rituals, customs, mode of marriage, death ceremonies, method of burial of dead bodies, etc. In the case of Vishnu Shankar and others versus Girdhari Lal and others, reported in ILR 2018, MP 1174, His Lordship dilated upon the distinction between Mitakshara Kupasnari property and joint family property, while holding that a Mitakshara Kupasnari carries a definite concept. In the case of Bal Mukund Singh Gautam versus Srimati Nina Verma, reported in ILR 2016, MP 1112, His Lordship observed that to constitute any statement of fact as corrupt practice under Section 123 of the Representation of People Act 1951, same must reflect on personal character or conduct of the candidate. Many such judgments reflect his wisdom, legal acumen, and articulation. But paucity of time persuades me to move forward. Beyond his impeccable legal acumen, His Lordship has been a mentor, a role model, and a source of inspiration to all of us. His humanity, kindness, and professionalism have earned him the respect and admiration of colleagues, staff, lawyers, and litigants alike. He has not only presided over cases with impartiality and compassion, but has also fostered an environment of camaraderie and mutual respect within these hallowed halls. As an administrative judge of Gwalior Bench, His Lordship played the role of elderly and big brotherly figure with a sense of responsibility and compatibility with bar and bench alike. His visionary initiative, Samadhan Aapke Dwar, stands as a testament to innovative governance. His anxiety to harmonize the efforts of different diverse government bodies, including revenue, police, judiciary, forest, local bodies, and electricity department, deserves appreciation. He tried to transform administrative machinery into a beacon of efficiency. This is like rewriting of narrative of alternative dispute resolution or taking the bull by horn so that no dispute may haunt the common man for common problems. Role of his lordship was instrumental in enhancing the infrastructure and amenities for our district courts, especially at District Gwalior. In our court premises also, beautification of the walkway, renovation of temple, refurbishment of the library, and renovation of staff chambers brought a sense of well-being and comfort. On personal front, we all judges would miss his presence in the tea club, where his guidance and laughter always kept us refreshing and updated. For me, his departure is a personal loss. I remember my first week of judgeship in April 2016, when I was posted at Gwalior bench after taking oath. I remember the days when in the same premises and corridors, his elder brotherly guidance always paved my way. Although we were in acquaintance in our days at bar, but after elevation, interaction and sharing the bench with him gave me more opportunities to get closer to him. I relished all my moments with him, whether traveling together, sitting together in tea club, as members of administrative committees, or sharing the bench. His persona has warmth filled with love and affection. Personally, I am going to miss all these things. Not to forget his popularity over social media, which made him much sought after personality wherever and whenever we visited any place with him. As his lordship embarks on the next phase of his journey, we extend our heartfelt gratitude for his years of dedicated service. Through his presence, though his presence will be deeply missed, his memories will be cherished by us forever. May his retirement be filled with joy, fulfillment, and well-deserved relaxation. Not only Justice Arya, but also Mrs. Arya has always been equally warm and hospitable to all of us. She has extended support to his lordship to perform his duties. She equally deserves appreciation. Sahir Ludhianvi ne kaha hai, sansar ki har shay ka itna hi fasana hai, ik dhund se aana hai, ek dhund mein jana hai. I, on my behalf and on behalf of my sister and brother judges, as well as officers of the registry of this court, wish Honorable Shri Justice Rohit Arya, Mrs. Arya, and their two daughters a very happy, healthy, prosperous, and glorious life ahead. May God shower on them choicest blessings for all the times to come. Thank you.
माननीय प्रशासनिक न्यायमूर्ति श्री रोहित आर्य जी, माननीय न्यायमूर्ति श्री आनंद पाठक जी, माननीय न्यायमूर्ति श्रीमती सुनीता यादव जी, माननीय न्यायमूर्ति श्री मिलिंद रमेश फटके जी, माननीय न्यायमूर्ति श्री रूपेश चंद बासने जी, माननीय न्यायमूर्ति श्री राजेंद्र कुमार बानी जी, माननीय न्यायमूर्ति श्री राजेंद्र कुमार जी, माननीय न्यायमूर्ति माननीय न्यायमूर्ति के परिवारजन, श्री अंकुर मोदी, श्री रोहित मिश्रा, अतिरिक्त महाअधिवक्तागण, मध्यप्रदेश उच्च न्यायालय खंडपीठ ग्वालियर, मध्यप्रदेश राज्य अधिवक्ता परिषद के वरिष्ठ सदस्य श्री जयप्रकाश मिश्रा जी, श्री प्रवीण निवासकर, डिप्टी सॉलिसिटर जनरल ऑफ इंडिया, प्रधान जिला एवं सत्र न्यायाधीश श्री पी सी गुप्ता जी, माननीय प्रिंसिपल रजिस्ट्रार एवं रजिस्ट्री के सभी अधिकारीगण, आदरणीय वरिष्ठ अधिवक्तागण, सचिव श्री महेश गोयल जी, सदस्यगण, उच्च न्यायालय अभिभाषक संघ ग्वालियर, आज हम यहाँ माननीय न्यायमूर्ति श्री रोहित आर्या जी को विदाई देने के लिए एकत्रित हुए हैं। माननीय न्यायमूर्ति श्री रोहित आर्या जी को ग्वालियर बार की ओर से धन्यवाद करना चाहता हूँ, जिन्होंने अपने योगदान से हमारे कानूनी प्रणाली को मजबूती और न्याय को अधिक उच्च स्तर तक पहुंचा है। माननीय न्यायमूर्ति श्री रोहित आर्या जी के निरंतर प्रयासों के माध्यम से समाज को न्याय मिला है। उनकी विशेष उपस्थिति हमारे लिए प्रेरणा स्रोत रही है। आपके समुद्र व्यवहार से समस्त अध्यक्षागण हमेशा प्रसन्न रहे हैं। आपके सेवानिवृत्त होने के इस समय पर हम आपके आभारी हैं और हम जानते हैं कि आपके उच्च आदर्श और सेवा समाज के लिए महत्वपूर्ण रहेगी। हम आपके सुखमय एवं स्वस्थ जीवन की कामना करते हैं। धन्यवाद।
Honorable Administrative Judge, Shri Justice Rohit Arya and other companion judges of the High Court, Shri Pavan Pathak, President of Gwalior Bar Association, Shri Praveen Nevaskar, Deputy Solicitor General of India, Shri Prem Singh Badoria, Chairman, State Bar Council, Shri Jitendra Sharma, Member of Bar Council of India, Senior Advocates, Staff of the Registry, Family Members of the Honorable Judges, Ladies and Gentlemen. We gather today to celebrate the remarkable career and achievements of a true pillar of the Madhya Pradesh High Court, my Lord Justice Rohit Arya, who demits the office as an administrative judge of this court today, on 27th of April 2024. My Lord's journey in the field of law started with his birth on 28th of April 1962. He completed his primary education from N.I. Besant School in Allahabad. And thereafter, my Lord did his class 10th from Queen's College, Varanasi, and class 12th from Government Inter College, Allahabad. He earned his BA degree from Aloysius College, Jabalpur, and LLB degree from Rani Durgavati Vishwavidyalaya. My Lord started his illustrious career in law in August 1984, when he enrolled with the Bar Council. His expertise spanned over 29 years across various legal domains, including civil laws, commercial laws, arbitration, administrative service, tax laws. Over the years, he represented a diverse range of clients, including central government, State Bank of India, telecom department, employees, State Insurance Corporation, and Income Tax Department. He also represented various banks. In recognition of his legal acumen, my Lord was designated as a senior advocate by the High Court of Madhya Pradesh on 26th of August 2003. Soon after designation, my Lord became the most sought after counsel in the High Court and was regularly engaged for matters in other High Courts as well as in the Honorable Supreme Court. Pressure of work compelled my Lord to shift his bases from Madhya Pradesh to Delhi, where he practiced in the Supreme Court and where he had one of the busiest law chambers. My Lord was sworn in as a judge of the High Court of Madhya Pradesh on September 16th, 2013, and became a permanent judge on March 26, 2015. His illustrious career is a testament to his dedication and commitment to the field of law. My Lord presided as a judge in Gwalior Bench from September 2013 till July 2017, whereafter he was transferred to Indore Bench, where he served as a judge from July 17 till October 21. My Lord was handed over the reins of administration of justice in the Gwalior Bench as an administrative judge on 25th of October 2021. My Lord's tenure as an administrative judge in this bench was most remarkable. My Lord is a live thesaurus on any subject of law. He has profound knowledge of his of the basic concepts of law, because of which he is able to get to the nerve of any dispute almost immediately. His ability of having a quick grasp of the matter, poised with clear understanding of the basic law on the subject, enabled him to come up with a solution which is finely balanced, keeping both the facts and law in view. In almost all the hearings, my Lords always insisted the advocates to clearly lay out the proposition of law upon which the case is sought to be premised. With his deep understanding of basic concepts, most of my Lord's judgment are purely based on first principles of law and attending facts around it. One would rarely find unnecessary reliance on series of judicial precedents and pronouncement on the issues which are already well settled, due to which my Lord's orders and judgments are crisp, short, and to the point, without unnecessary discussions on not so relevant facts. After having discerned relevant facts, the rest of the judgment was a pure discourse of law, which is a feast to any legal mind. My Lord, while balancing the scales of justice, showed immense compassion, especially in matters relating to regularization of service or counting of past services of Class 3 and Class 4 employees. Compassion was an important guiding factor for my Lords while interpreting and determining meaning and purpose of any rule or regulation in the service jurisprudence. My Lord was also conscious of his duties towards public at large and the society as a judge. While debunking mischievous PILs right at the threshold, my Lord rightly entertained some PILs, raising a genuine public cause. The completion of construction of the new district court building, which project was lying idle for many years, was a result of my Lord's farsightedness for the ever-rising need of a bigger court campus to meet out the requirements of both the advocates and litigants alike. Gwalior Bar would remain indebted to my Lord for his relentless effort which led to the completion of the new district court building. Similarly, my Lord's effort for revival and cleansing of the Swarnarekha River and the Gwalior Suti would always be remembered. My Lord has pronounced many landmark judgments during his tenure as a judge and had been instrumental in laying down of many landmark judgments as an advocate. I would be understating if I said that my Lord was a maverick of a lawyer and a marvel of a judge. It feels very heavy in the heart to bid farewell and goodbye to my Lord, because my Lord had created a special place for himself in the heart of every advocate in this bar with his wit and humor. But the march of time stops for none, and we all have to abide by it with a heavy heart, but with a heart full of good wishes for healthy and satisfying retired life. I, on behalf of the Office of the Advocate General, bid farewell to my Lord. May God bless you and your family with a healthy and long life.
Honorable Sri Justice Rohit Arya Sahab, Administrative Judge, Honorable Sri Justice Sri Anand Pathak Sahab, and all companions sitting on dais, and Honorable members of family of Honorable Judges, Sri Pawan Pathak, President High Court Bar Association Gwalior, Sri Ankur Modi, Additional Court General for State of Madhya Pradesh, Sri Prem Singh Bhadauria, Chairman State Bar Council Madhya Pradesh, Sri Jiten Kumar Sharma, Member Bar Council of India, Sri J.P. Mishra Ji and Sri Rajesh Shukla Ji, Member State Bar Council Madhya Pradesh, Respected Senior Advocates and Members of Bar, Sri A.K. Mishra, Principal Registrar, Sri Hiten Devi, OSD, and other officers of the registry. As we are here together today to bid farewell to a distinguished member of the judiciary, it is with both sense of gratitude and admiration that we reflect over the remarkable career of His Lordship, Honorable Sri Justice Rohit Arya. For more than a decade, His Lordship has presided over four courts, our courts, with wisdom, integrity, and persistent dedication to the pursuit of justice. Throughout His Lordship's tenure on the bench, he has been paragon of fairness and impartiality, earning the respect of admiration of colleagues, lawyers, and litigants alike. His Lordship has approached every case with sincere commitment of upholding the principles of law and ensuring that justice is well served. The legal acumen of His Lordship is reflected from his judgments. Beyond his legal acumen, His Lordship has highest standards of professionalism and civility. He has treated all the who appeared before him with dignity, earning and his reputation being not only fair adjudication, but also compassionate listener and thoughtful decision maker. His Lordship has led to the completion of our new district building, which has been pending for a long time. Thanks for His Lordship's continuous efforts, the building has completed during its tenure, and now the district court is in the process of moving to the new additionally, and renovation of temple has enhanced the peaceful and spiritual atmosphere of this of place of justice. His Lordship always comfort with the both litigants and advocates. The construction of walking providing relief for the scoring summers, the addition of sitting sheds of litigants for litigants, the establishment of Sachi Parlor and creation of beautiful library are just a few examples of His Lordship. In addition, we must acknowledge His Lordship ground initiative Samadhan Sampardwar, which has showcased our governance of finance, this program has brought rather various government departments. His lordship contributes to the administration of justice, have left an indelible mark of legal system, and we will deeply miss who will always heard privilege of appearing before him. On behalf of Union of India and my own behalf, I would like to extend heartfelt thanks to his lordship for his years dedicated service. Wish him with healthy, long and fulfilling retirement. May he enjoy his well-deserved time with his family and friends.
माननीय प्रशासनिक न्यायमूर्ति श्री रोहित आर्य जी, माननीय न्यायमूर्ति श्री आनंद पाठक जी, वरिष्ठ न्यायमूर्ति एवं उपस्थित सभी न्यायमूर्तिगण, श्री पवन पाठक अध्यक्ष उच्च न्यायालय वासक संघ ग्वालियर, श्री अंकुर मोदी जी अतिरिक्त महाधिवक्ता मध्यप्रदेश शासन, श्री प्रवीण निवासकर असिस्टेंट सॉलिसिटर जनरल भारत सरकार, माननीय अधीनस्थ न्यायालय के न्यायाधीशगण, श्री प्रिंसिपल श्री जीतन शर्मा जी सदस्य बार काउंसिल ऑफ इंडिया, जयप्रकाश मिश्रा राजेश शुक्ला सदस्य राज्य अधिवक्ता परिषद, वरिष्ठ अधिवक्तागण एवं उपस्थित अधिवक्ता का परिवार के सभी सदस्यगण, श्री प्रिंसिपल रजिस्ट्रार श्री ए के मिश्रा जी एवं ओएसडी श्री जितेंद्र द्विवेदी जी एंड उपस्थित सभी मित्तल साहब एवं उपस्थित सभी वरिष्ठजन, उपस्थित सभी माननीय न्यायमूर्तिगण के परिवारजन, आज हम सभी माननीय न्यायमूर्ति रोहित आर्य जी के सेवानिवृत्त होने पर उन्हें विदाई समारोह देने उपस्थित हुए। श्री महान माननीय रोहित आर्य जी की जीवन यात्रा दिनांक 28/4/2062 में प्रारंभ हुई थी। पारिवारिक संस्कार एवं सामाजिक जीवन के द्वारा प्राप्त संस्कारों से परिपूर्ण जीवन शैली के माध्यम से अपने जीवन को संसार की चकाचौंध से प्रभावित हुए बिना अपने व्यक्तित्व को स्कूली एवं महाविद्यालयीन शिक्षा के माध्यम से धीरे धीरे क्रमशः हायर सेकेंडरी परीक्षा वर्ष 1977 में एवं इंटरमीडिएट माध्यमिक परिषद उत्तर प्रदेश से उत्तीर्ण की, तदुपरांत स्नातक परीक्षा वर्ष 1981 में एवं एलएलबी की परीक्षा वर्ष 1984 में रानी दुर्गावती विश्वविद्यालय जबलपुर से एक मूर्तिकार के समान साधारण मिट्टी से भव्य प्रतिमा की अवधारणा के समान विधि व्यवसाय का संकल्प लेते हुए आपके द्वारा मध्य प्रदेश राज्य अधिवक्ता परिषद में दिनांक 10/8/1984 को अपना पंजीयन कराते हुए विधि व्यवसाय जबलपुर में प्रारंभ किया। विधि व्यवसाय के दौरान आपके द्वारा सिविल, श्रम, संवैधानिक, प्रशासनिक, टैक्सेशन, कॉरपोरेशन, कॉमर्शियल, आर्बिट्रेशन, डोमेस्टिक आदि में दक्षता हासिल करते हुए एक विशेषज्ञ के रूप में अपना आपको स्थापित किया। माननीय न्यायमूर्ति के विधि ज्ञान के आधार पर दिनांक 26/4/2003 को मध्य प्रदेश उच्च न्यायालय द्वारा वरिष्ठ अभिभाषक के रूप में मनोनीत किया गया। तदुपरांत माननीय के विधि ज्ञान के आधार पर इस न्याय मंदिर का दिनांक 12/9/2013 को न्यायमूर्ति के रूप में न्यायदान करने एवं दीनहीन को न्याय प्रदान करने हेतु नियुक्त किया गया और दिनांक 26/3/2015 को स्थायी न्यायमूर्ति के रूप में नियुक्त किया गया। माननीय न्यायमूर्ति द्वारा अपने कार्यकाल के दौरान जबलपुर, इंदौर, ग्वालियर में अपनी सेवाएं देते हुए अनेकों न्याय दर्शन प्रतिपादित किए गए जो हम सभी का मार्ग प्रशस्त कर रहे हैं। अब माननीय को मध्य प्रदेश उच्च न्यायालय द्वारा समय समय पर जो भी दायित्व दिए गए उनका सफलतापूर्वक निर्वहन किया गया। माननीय न्यायमूर्ति को एक अभिभाषक के रूप में भी हमने ग्वालियर में देखा और माननीय को न्यायमूर्ति के रूप में भी हमने उनके चिर परिचित अंदाज में कार्य करते हुए देखा। माननीय न्यायमूर्ति के न्यायपति के रूप में कुछ खट्टे कुछ मीठे अनुभव भी हमने प्राप्त किए जो हमेशा माननीय न्यायमूर्ति का स्मरण कराते रहेंगे। माननीय न्यायमूर्ति के प्रशासनिक न्यायमूर्ति के रूप में रहते हुए उनके प्रशासनिक अनुभव का भी हम सभी को लाभ प्राप्त हुआ, जिसमें विशेष रूप से इस न्याय मंदिर के परिवार परिसर में श्री हनुमान मंदिर का जीर्णोद्धार जो कि हम सभी को माननीय न्यायमूर्ति का स्मरण कराते रहेगी। माननीय न्यायमूर्ति को प्रशासनिक अनुभव के आधार पर उन्होंने आवश्यक कर्मचारियों एवं जनमानस की सुविधाओं को ध्यान में रखते हुए हम सबके उन्हें समय समय पर जो स्मरण कराया उन सभी कार्यों का प्रयास माननीय न्यायालय द्वारा किया गया। अर्थात माननीय न्यायमूर्ति द्वारा अपने कार्यकाल के दौरान सभी वर्ग के यथोचित स्थान रखते हुए न्यायदान अब सार्वजनिक हित कार्य भी माननीय न्यायमूर्ति द्वारा किए गए। माननीय न्यायमूर्ति द्वारा सार्वजनिक हित को दृष्टिगत रखते हुए अपराध की उत्पत्ति पर ध्यान आकर्षित करते हुए प्रदेश में पहली बार समाधान आपके द्वार योजना के अंतर्गत लाखों प्रकरणों का निराकरण न्यायालय में आने से पूर्व भी कराया गया, जो अपने आप में माननीय न्यायमूर्ति की अनूठी पहल है, जिससे कई परिवार लाभान्वित हुए। इस संबंध में माननीय के लिए यह कहना भी उचित होगा, किसी को अपनी खूबियों का एहसास नहीं होता, सरप्रस्त मिलना इत्तेफाक नहीं होता। अच्छा ही कुछ किया होगा हमने, वरना आप रहे साथ विश्वास नहीं होता। माननीय न्यायमूर्ति दिनांक 28/4/2024 को सेवानिवृत्त हो रहे हैं और सेवानिवृत्ति के उपरांत मैं मध्य प्रदेश राज्य अधिवक्ता परिषद के अध्यक्ष होने के नाते मध्य प्रदेश राज्य अधिवक्ता परिषद के प्रत्येक सदस्यों एवं प्रदेश के सभी अधिवक्ताओं की ओर से आपको सेवानिवृत्ति के उपरांत सफलतापूर्वक कार्यकाल पूर्ण करने पर हार्दिक शुभकामनाएं देता हूं एवं परम पिता परमात्मा से प्रार्थना करता हूं कि इस अर्धविराम के बाद आप एक नए अध्याय की शुरुआत करते हुए स्वस्थ प्रसन्न एवं दीनहीन को न्याय प्रदान करने में कराने में अपना पूर्ण सहयोग प्रदान करते रहेंगे तथा आपकी कार्यप्रणाली के आधार पर हमें विश्वास है कि आप परमात्मा द्वारा दिए गए शेष जीवन को सर्वहारा वर्ग के हितों के लिए भी कार्य करते रहेंगे। आप अवश्य ऐसे कार्य करेंगे जिनका अनुसरण करके हम लोग भी लाभान्वित होते रहेंगे। माननीय, आप हमेशा ही हमारे दिलों में हैं। आपकी बरसों की सेवा व समर्पण जो आपने अपना कर्म मानते हुए किया है, उन सभी से हम प्रेरणा लेते रहेंगे और आपको कुछ खट्टी मीठी यादों के रूप में आपको याद करते रहेंगे। साथ ही हम अपने आप को भी सौभाग्यशाली समझते हैं कि आपके साथ अभिभाषक एवं न्यायमूर्ति के रूप में अपनत्व भरे वातावरण में कार्य करने का अवसर प्राप्त हुआ, जिसके आधार पर आपसे ब्रह्म प्रार्थना करता हूँ कि आप इस गालब ऋषि की तपोभूमि को याद करते हुए आप अपना आवागमन निरंतर जारी रखेंगे। इस बार ने आपको बहुत चाहा है और आपसे आशा ही नहीं बल्कि पूर्ण रूप से विश्वास करते हैं कि आप कबीर की उस पंक्ति जैसा नहीं करेंगे, पत्ता टूटा डाल से ले गई पवन उड़ाए, अब के बिछड़े ना मिले दूर पड़े है जाए। मैं एक बार पुनः इन्हीं सब शुभकामनाओं के साथ परमपिता परमात्मा से प्रार्थना करता हूँ कि आप सेवानिवृत्ति के उपरांत अपने परिवार सहित सुखमय आनंदमय प्रश्नचित मुद्रा में अपने जीवन व्यतीत करेंगे। अंत में आपके बारे में बस इतना ही कहूँगा कि शाम हो शहर खुशियों का तराना रहे, कुछ भी हो मुस्कराने की का बहाना रहे, आप जिंदगी में इतना खुश रहें कि हर पल आपको आपका दीवाना रहे। बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद इन्हीं सब शुभकामनाओं से।
ऑनरेबल श्री जस्टिस रोहित आर्या जी, एडमिनिस्ट्रेटिव जज हाई कोर्ट ऑफ मध्य प्रदेश बेंच एट ग्वालियर। ऑनरेबल श्री जस्टिस आनंद पाठक, जज हाई कोर्ट ऑफ एमपी बेंच एट ग्वालियर। अदर ऑनरेबल कंपेनियन जजेस सिटिंग ऑन द डाइस, ऑनरेबल फॉर्मर जजेस प्रेजेंट इन द फंक्शन, फैमिली मेंबर्स ऑफ द ऑनरेबल जजेस, श्री पीसी गुप्ता जी प्रिंसिपल डिस्ट्रिक्ट जज एंड अदर जजेस कम फ्रॉम द डिस्ट्रिक्ट जुडिशरी, श्री पवन पाठक प्रेसिडेंट हाईकोर्ट बार एसोसिएशन ग्वालियर, श्री अंकुर मोदी एडिशनल सोलिसिटर जनरल गवर्नमेंट ऑफ मध्य प्रदेश, श्री प्रेम सिंह भदौरिया चेयरमैन, श्री जयप्रकाश मिश्रा, श्री राजेश शुक्ला मेंबर्स ऑफ द स्टेट बार काउंसिल ऑफ मध्य प्रदेश, श्री प्रवीण वास्कर असिस्टेंट सोलिसिटर जनरल गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया, श्री ए के मिश्रा प्रिंसिपल रजिस्ट्रार ऑफ द एमपी हाईकोर्ट बेंच एट ग्वालियर, श्री हितेंद्र द्विवेदी रजिस्ट्रार ऑफिसर ऑन स्पेशल ड्यूटी एंड अदर ऑफिसर्स and employees of the registry, respected senior advocates and respected members of the bar, ladies and gentlemen, we have gathered here to bid farewell to Honorable Justice Sri Rohit Arya, who is demitting office tomorrow, 27th of the April 2024, after serving for more than 10 years as judge of the High Court of MP and 2.5 years of serving to this Honorable Court as administrative judge at the High Court of MP bench at Gwalior. But in this short span of time, through his humor and wit. He had endeared all of us. His contribution to the justice delivery system has been immense. These proceedings are meant to share, honor our thoughts on the own and appreciate Justice Arya's career, share words of goodwill, best wishes and express gratitude to His Lordship on behalf of the Bar Council of India, who desired to say something on the steadiness, integrity, hardworking, fairness and uprightness of His Lordship. Born on 28th of April 1962 in a well-reputed family, his father, late Sri B.L.R., was a joint director, Medical and Health Services, State of UP. His grandfather was an honorary magistrate and Honorable Justice Sri Gulab Gupta, retired Chief Justice of the Himachal Pradesh, an ex-judge of this Honorable Court, is his uncle. His other relatives are also highly educated and well-placed. Honorable Justice Sri Rohit Arya studied at Allahabad, Varanasi, Jabalpur and obtained the degree of law from RDBP University, Jabalpur. He was enrolled as an advocate in the State Bar Council of Madhya Pradesh 40 years back and practiced in all fields and was designated as senior advocate on 26th August 2003. Your Lordship has remained standing counsel for Income Tax Department in MP High Court from 1999 to 2012. Later on, he shifted to New Delhi and practiced in Honorable Supreme Court and was impaneled as senior standing counsel for the state of MP in 2007. He also remained senior standing counsel for the tax department in the state of Chhattisgarh and as standing counsel for the central government from 1994 to 2000 in Central Administrative Tribunal. He also remains standing counsel for BSNL in MP High Court, Central Administrative Tribunal, Jabalpur Bench from 2003 to 2013. And represented the Telecom Department in MP High Court, Central Administrative Tribunal, Jabalpur Bench, and represented various banks from 1991 to 2003. He was elevated as Judge of the Madhya Pradesh High Court on 12-9-2013 and had remained posted as Judge of MP High Court Bench at Gwalior between September 2003 to July 2017 before his transfer to Indore Bench. However, as fate would have it, we were again blessed to have his presence as administrative judge of the Gwalior bench with effect from October 2021. During his term as administrative judge of the Gwalior bench, His Lordship initiated Samadhan Aapke Dwar Yojana, which was a scheme to overcome the burden of pending litigation faced by the judicial system, which is biggest challenge for this institution. This scheme was initially made applicable in the districts of territorial jurisdiction of the Gwalior bench. However, aimed at settling legal disputes at pre-litigation and under litigation stage through compounding and mediation. After huge success of this scheme in these districts, it was made applicable to the whole of MP at the initiation of Honorable Chief Justice. In the last phase of this scheme, 43,68,676 cases have been decided and the credit for the same goes to Honorable Justice Sri Arya. He has always worried about the upliftment of country from the rural level for an organic growth of the country and bringing the villages in the mainstream. At this moment, I cannot stop myself from quoting a verse reflecting His Lordship. माना इस जहां को न गुलजार कर सके, माना कि इस जहां को न गुलजार कर सके, कुछ खार तो कम कर गए गुजरे जिधर से हम. Spite of so much of work, we have never seen His Lordship show a sign of the burden or stress of work. In fact, the atmosphere of His court was always been light and conducive. Perhaps the same can be attributed to His sound knowledge of the law and His experience of working in different fields. Through His fairness in conduct of cases, the trust which people reposed in our judicial system has been greatly enhanced. It is due to His hard-working, diligence, adhering to the professional ethics and ability to work in a team that has gained the trust of members of the bar who feel Him as one of their own. At this juncture, I am again constrained टू कोट वन मोर शेर, सूरज हूँ जिंदगी की रमक छोड़ जाऊंगा, मैं चला भी गया तो शफक छोड़ जाऊंगा। ऑन द मोस्ट नेसेसरी एट्रीब्यूट्स ऑफ ए जज इज टू मेंटेन बैलेंस व्हाइल प्रोनाउंसिंग द जजमेंट्स बिटवीन द इंटरप्रिटेशन एंड एप्लीकेशन ऑफ द लॉ। व्हाट हैज इम्प्रेस्ड अस ऑल इज हिज रॉक सॉलिड सेल्फ बिलीफ एंड फोर्टीनेस। ही हैज रिमेंड काम थ्रू एडवर्सिटी एंड हैज बीन ए सोर्स ऑफ स्ट्रेंथ फॉर अस। एज आई सेड बिफोर, इन द स्पैन ऑफ 2 years ही हैज इंडियर्ड ऑल ऑफ अस इन हिज मेथड्स ऑफ वर्किंग। सेंसिटिविटी टुवर्ड्स पुअर डाउनट्रोडन और एनी अदर पर्सन इन नीड एज वेल एज हिज क्लियर अप्रोच एंड द सेम बींग इन पब्लिक इंटरेस्ट वॉज वेरी क्लियर। हिज लॉर्डशिप हैज ऑलवेज बीन एन एफिशियंट एंड डिवोटेड जज एंड थस इंस्पायर्स ऑल ऑफ अस टू डू अवर बिट टू कंट्रीब्यूट टू दिस सिस्टम। आई होप दैट ही विल रिमेन एक्टिव एंड एसोसिएटेड विद अदर स्ट्रीम ऑफ लॉ एंड आई होप ही विल रिमेन एक्टिव टुवर्ड्स दिस सोसाइटी। ऑनरेबल जस्टिस आर्या's कंट्रीब्यूशन हैज बीन इमेंस इन इटरेटिंग लैंडमार्क जजमेंट्स दैट विल लाइटन द फ्रेटर्निटी फॉर ए लॉन्ग टाइम टू कम। वी विल नेवर बी एबल टू फॉरगेट दैट ड्यू टू योर लॉर्डशिप्स इंटरवेंशन सिमिलर ट्रीटमेंट हैज बीन एक्सटेंडेड टू द मिनिस्ट्रियल स्टाफ ऑफ दिस रजिस्ट्री ऑन नेशनल फेस्टिवल्स एट ग्वालियर बेंच एंड टिल द एग्जिस्टेंस ऑफ दिस प्रमाइस द लॉयर्स विल नॉट बी एबल टू फॉरगेट माई लॉर्ड फॉर हिज काइंड सपोर्ट इन इनकरेजिंग द लॉयर्स एंड लिटिगेंट्स टू एंटर पीसफुली इन दिस प्रमाइस आफ्टर गेटिंग आशीर्वाद ऑफ लॉर्ड हनुमान जी। ड्यू टू पॉसिटी ऑफ टाइम आई विल नॉट बी एबल टू रेफर द लैंडमार्क जजमेंट्स रेंडर्ड बाई ऑनरेबल जस्टिस आर्या बट इट कैन बी समड अप दैट देयर रिफ्लेक्ट्स हिज कमांड ऑन लॉ राइटियसनेस एंड फियर्स इंडिपेंडेंस। व्हाइल समिंग अप आई रेफर अनदर कोट। गुजर जाती है यूं तो हर शाम उम्मीदों में गुजर जाती है, आज कुछ बात है जो शाम पर रोना आया। टुडे एज वी विड हिम फेयरवेल फ्रॉम दिस ऑनरेबल हाई कोर्ट प्लीज एक्सेप्ट अवर बेस्ट विशेस एंड वी प्रे अवर ऑलमाइटी गॉड टू ग्रांट हिम लॉन्गेविटी गुड हेल्थ एंड हैप्पीनेस एंड एन एक्टिव एंड फुलफिलिंग नेक्स्ट चैप्टर। थैंक यू।
प्रिंसिपल रजिस्ट्रार श्री अखिलेश कुमार मिश्रा, ऑफिसर ऑन स्पेशल ड्यूटी श्री हितेन द्विवेदी, रिस्पेक्टेड मेंबर्स ऑफ द डिस्ट्रिक्ट जुडिशरी, ऑफिसर्स एंड ऑफिशियल्स ऑफ द रजिस्ट्री, लेडीज एंड जेंटलमैन, एज आई एड्रेस यू टुडे ऑन दिस मोमेंटस ओकेजन आई एम फिल्ड विद मेरियड ऑफ इमोशंस एज आई बिड फेयरवेल टू अ चैप्टर ऑफ माय लाइफ that has been incredibly fulfilling. I am indeed overwhelmed by the love and affection showered on me by each one of you during my tenure at Gwalior, and the kind words spoken about me by each of the distinguished speakers. After 40 years of legal profession as an advocate and then as a judge, the time has come for me to pass on the gavel to a new generation of lawyers. At this hour, after profusely thanking the Almighty for everything, I remember my late parents and seek their blessings. I pray the Almighty may rest their soul in peace. In 1979, after finishing school, I went from Allahabad to Jabalpur to continue my studies, as due to some disturbance in Allahabad University, academic sessions were running late. After graduation from St. Aloysius College, Jabalpur, and while pursuing law studies, I entered the esteemed chamber of my late uncle, Honorable Justice Gulab Gupta, a luminary deeply dedicated to the cause of social justice and legal empowerment. I worked hard doing various tasks there, which helped me a lot in my career later as a lawyer. During my legal studies, I spent a lot of time in judges' library and courtrooms observing proceedings and learning about things worked there. I learned with keen interest, thereby honing understanding of judicial decorum, court etiquettes, and the art of persuasive argumentations, including imbibing wisdom from seasoned lawyers, middle-level practitioners, and budding talents alike. Although I was advised to start my practice directly at the Supreme Court, but I felt unsure due to my young age, as I was only 22. Then I met late Shri Y.S. Dharmadhikari, a well-known legal figure and legal titan of his era. In a pivotal exchange, Mr. Dharmadhikari inquired as to my aspirations, whether I sought to be an advocate on record or an eloquent arguing counsel. Without hesitation, I declared my ambition to pursue the latter path. Thus guided, Mr. Dharmadhikari recommended that I commence my practice in Jabalpur, albeit with the condition that I establish my independence, separate from the shadow of my esteemed uncle, Justice Gulab Gupta. Generously facilitating my transition, Mr. Dharmadhikari arranged for my accommodation in a spacious two-bedroom apartment situated right down Jabalpur, a gesture for which I remain profoundly indebted. Thus, I started my journey under his benevolent mentorship in September 1984. I am indebted to Senior Advocate Shri M.L. Jaiswal, practicing in Jabalpur High Court, for a mature fatherly advice. In 1985, he suggested me to acquire the extensive law library of late Shri V.B. Rai from Katni, a senior counsel at Katni, as he had no one to succeed him as a lawyer. Embracing this suggestion, I secured a personal loan of rupees 15,000 from a nationalized bank to procure the library, which to this day stand as a cherished asset replete with legal tomes of All India Reporters spanning from 1922 to 1984 and onwards, alongside sundry legal journals like MPLJ, MP Law Times, MPJRs, and different law and other general books. The establishment of this library within my office lent it a rich look. I married Vandana in the year 1990, and we stayed in that house for 2 years. Thereafter, we shifted to our new bungalow at South Civil Lines, Jabalpur in December 1992 with our 3-month-old daughter, Avantika. of course now in London, as a professional in tax audit and accounts. The younger daughter Anushka, though came late, born on 17-2-2002, but I'm happy to note that she is completing BTech from IIT Delhi around the same period when I'm demitting the office. Over the next 29 years, I practiced law in various legal areas, becoming senior advocate in 2003 at the age of 41. Was a profound moment for me, recognizing my years of experience and skill. Although I was offered justship in 2006, I chose to continue practicing law and move to Supreme Court. My eventual appointment as a judge in 2013 was, as I often reflect, was a tryst with my destiny. This decision was met with initial concern and reluctance from my family, but they eventually supported me, understanding the inherent nobility of the endeavor and importance of serving society through the legal system. I also felt that after dedicating 29 years to law practice, it was my duty to contribute further by becoming a judge, ensuring justice for all. I also believed that it was incumbent upon me to contribute meaningfully to society by engaging with apparatus of justice, a decision informed by my abiding gratitude towards the multitude of individuals, indigent litigants, and members of the legal fraternity alike who had contributed immeasurably to my journey as a lawyer. As I step down from the podium, I would like to share with you the key takeaways from my journey, a handful of information that might prove useful to the young advocates. Before preparing your brief, you should cultivate the art of listening well. You should allow your client to speak and divulge all the details of the case to gain insight into the matter. A well-organized brief case file halves the complications and doubles your confidence. Once you are in command of factual matrix, you are expected to know the law applicable to it. You should carefully read the relevant law. The idea of understanding the relevant law is to first carefully go through the aims and objects of the Act. Thereafter, you should pursue the definition clause and then come to the relevant section. You should read the section with a neutral mindset and assess how it is applicable to the facts of your case. Then comes researching for relevant case laws. While reading a case law, you should not go by the precedent, as the precedent is not made by the judges, but editors and staff of the publications. You should in fact cultivate the habit of going through the facts of the relevant case law and understand the context in which the law has been enunciated by the court. By doing so, you will be able to understand as to how close to the facts of your case are to that of the case, and then you should be able to select the closest case law in the given facts and circumstances of your case. Having understood the context in which the law has been laid down, you will be able to draft a more relevant, precise, and crisp brief on the subject. While preparing for your arguments, remember that knowledge is your greatest ally in the courtroom. You should be a master of facts and should be able to handle all queries on facts with supreme ease. Before beginning your arguments, you should frame your mind as to how you have to pilot and proceed in the case. The approach for admission and final hearing matters is a bit different. Anticipate the queries right from maintainability to merits and the counter arguments which may come your way. You should be able to meet them all with convictions and confidence. Even if you are appearing only to take adjournment in a case, get familiar with the facts of the case, because an opportunity can come your way to make a lasting impression on the judge. These days, courts are flooded with a plethora of cases and the time window for a short case is limited. You should be able to deliver the punchline in opening 2-3 sentences, embodying all the relevant facts so that the court gets to know the factual background. Similarly, in hearing party matters, you should be thorough with the record so that you may quote complete facts in detail and with assistance and of documents and answer the queries of the court. Make your case memorable through clear, concise, and persuasive arguments. You should perfect the art of persuasion and have exemplary court manners. Persuade the judge by logic and argumentative skills. If you find a judge not receptive to your point, leave that point and take up some other point, but revert back to the original point after you have made the judge receptive. Remember, even if you lose a case, a judge would never forget a logical point or argument put forth by you. Never rest your argument solely on the basis of case laws. You should read the case law to help facilitate articulation of your submissions. But the case law should not be the one and the only point of your submissions. As a lawyer, what is more important is presentation of a case. Whether you win a case or lose a case, we can only persuade a judge, but judgment is to be given by the judge only. Your performance in the court speaks for your publicity. Therefore, your performance in every case is important, whether it's a big or a small. Besides, your punctuality and availability play a crucial role in your success. You should be consistent at behalf in chamber and court both. You should have the habit of regularly coming to the court even if you don't have the case listed on that day. You can go to different courtrooms listening to the arguments or sit in the library to enrich your knowledge. Your mind should always engage in pursuit of knowledge and understanding, which will distinguish you intellectually. All these things help in shaping you as a good advocate, an advocate with original thinking. This would help you develop the art of visualizing different dimensions of a given case with different logical results. Your understanding of law should be such that you may give different logical shades, steadfast with the color of factual matrix, with the help of constructive interpretation of law. At this juncture, it is needless to say, they should always respect your seniors and give love and affection to your juniors. You should never lose your mental balance with clients, advocates, or in the court. It disturbs your entire line of thinking, and you may lose a case because of intemperate conduct or performance. In such situation, we say that you have identified yourself with the case. Losing or winning a case is not important. Preparation and performance enriches your experience, and that makes you a good advocate. Besides that, I am also impassioned by the belief that the strength of our judiciary lies not only or solely within the grand halls of our higher courts, but also with the steadfast dedication of our district judiciary, the first and the final court for the 85% of the litigating population. As statistics goes, only 15% cases come to the High Court, and only 8-9% cases go to Supreme Court. The district judiciary serves as the bedrock of our legal system, the first line of defense in the pursuit of justice for all. It is within the walls of our district courts and magistrates' courts that the fabric of our society is woven, where the rights of the vulnerable are protected. Yet, in our pursuit of justice, we must acknowledge the challenges that confront our district judiciary. Limited resources, overwhelming caseloads, and systematic inefficiencies threaten to erode the very pillars upon which the edifice of justice stands. But it is precisely in the face of these challenges that the strength of our resolve must shine the brightest. We must strive to empower our district judiciary, not merely with resources and infrastructure, but with the unwavering support of our collective commitment to justice. I am of the firm view that the members of the district judiciary require meaningful motivation and effective protection, ensuring congenial atmosphere for work. Then only we may nurture and expect a culture of excellence where every judge, every clerk, and every member judiciary is inspired to uphold the highest standards of integrity and impartiality and diligence. Above all, we must never lose sight of the human element that lies at the heart of our judiciary. Behind every case, every judgment, and every verdict, there are lives hanging in the balance, individuals seeking solace and redemption within the halls of justice. It is our solemn duty to ensure that every individual who walks through the doors of our courts is treated with dignity, respect, and compassion. Being a judge is not merely a profession. It's a vocation, an opportunity to make a tangible difference in the lives of those who come before us. Each decision we make has a far-reaching consequences that extend far beyond the confines of our courtrooms. Let us reaffirm our commitment to the strengthening of our district judiciary, not merely as an institution of law, but as a beacon of hope and justice for all. Let us stand united in our pursuit of a judiciary that is fair, accessible, and it is steadfast in its dedication to upholding the rights and liberties of every individual within our society. Together, let us strive to build a legal system that is not just blind, but compassionate, but not just punitive, but rehabilitative, but not just impartial, but empathetic. Let's be one trusted with hope for those who have been wronged, the voice of reason for those who seek truth, and the steadfast guardians of justice for all. In the words of Martin Luther King Jr., the arc of moral universe is long. The arc of moral universe is long, but it bends towards justice. Let us be the architects of that bend, shaping a future where justice prevails and equality reigns supreme. Reflecting on my tenure as on the bench, I am overwhelmed with the gratitude for the privilege and honor it has been to serve the community in this capacity. Every day, I have been entrusted with the sacred responsibility of upholding justice, fairness, and the rule of law. It has been a profound journey, one marked by both challenges and triumphs. And above all, it has been deeply rewarding. I am indebted to my esteemed brothers and sisters, both past and present, whose dedication to the pursuit of justice has inspired me and enriched my own journey. Together, we have strived to ensure that every individual who entered our courtrooms received a fair and impartial hearing, regardless of their background or circumstances. Most importantly, I am thankful to the Almighty for entrusting me with the solemn duty of dispensing justice. It has been a privilege to serve the community and citizens of my country, and I hope that my efforts have contributed in small measures to the betterment of society. In closing, I extend my deepest gratitude to all who have touched my heart and my life during my tenure as judge, including our principal registrar, Shri Akhilesh Kumar Mishra, officer on special duty, registrar Shri Hiten Dwivedi, secretarial staff comprising of Shri MVR Balaji Sharma, former secretary and currently deputy registrar at Indore bench, Yogesh Verma, assistant registrar, secretary श्री आनंद श्रीवास्तव, संजीव पेंडसे, श्री पवन धारकर, सीनियर पर्सनल असिस्टेंट मिसेस वर्षा चतुर्वेदी, पर्सनल असिस्टेंट श्री सुनील दुबे, रीडर श्री उदय भेलसा वाले, श्री दीपक ठाकुर, डाटा एंट्री ऑपरेटर श्री उत्तम सिंह बघेल, लॉ असिस्टेंट्स एम एस दिव्या भटनागर, प्रोटोकॉल ऑफिसर श्री अभिषेक भार्गव, असिस्टेंट प्रोटोकॉल ऑफिसर श्री हितेन सविता, श्री दीपक बांगर, श्री मनोज शर्मा, श्री नवीन करेलिया, श्री विनोद अहिरवार, श्री योगेश लिखारे, श्री रजत सागर, श्री दीपक मिश्रा, प्रिंसिपल सिस्टम एनालिस्ट श्री सत्येंद्र शर्मा, जूनियर सिस्टम एनालिस्ट श्री आनंद सोनारे, सीनियर कंप्यूटर प्रोग्रामर असिस्टेंट श्री आलोक ओझा, अशर्स श्री गया प्रसाद, श्री नरेश पांडे, श्री यूनिस खान, पीएसओ श्री रंजीत भदौरिया, श्री योगेंद्र सिंह जादौन, श्री रवि राजावत, ड्राइवर धनंजय झा, कुक्स श्री उदय भान, श्री राम कृपाल गौड़, सपोर्टिंग स्टाफ श्री आशा राम रजक, श्री बाबूलाल बाथम, श्री सोनू खरे, श्री लतीफ अली, श्री सुरेश रजक, श्री राजकुमार नामदेव, श्री केदार मौर्य, श्री महेंद्र पाल, श्री राजा राम कुशवाहा, श्री सुखराम जाटव, श्री अमजद खान, श्री अनिल, श्री दिलीप रजक, श्री राघवेंद्र सिंह एंड श्री अमित करसोलिया एंड ऑल अदर्स हु हैड बीन एसोसिएटेड विद मी इन सम वे और द अदर। योर सपोर्ट, गाइडेंस एंड फ्रेंडशिप हैव मेंट द वर्ल्ड टू मी एंड आई विल कैरी स्वीट मेमोरीज एंड द लेसन्स लर्न्ड शेयर्ड विद यू ऑल फॉर द रेस्ट ऑफ माय लाइफ। थैंक यू। माय मेन रूल ऑफ लॉ dominate Indian democracy and polity, indeed with parliamentary supremacy, may justice always prevail. Jai Hind, Jai Bharat.